So, good morning, friends. This is Dr. Payman Swami, Professor, Department of ECE. Today, we can discuss about the noise effect. What are the noise available in amplitude modulation? So, that is noise in AM. AM stands for amplitude modulation. Similarly, you can see the remaining other modulation also, which is available in the AM, that is the DSBSC wave, and also SSBSC. So, both cases, we are suppressing carrier signal and transmitting only double sideband and single sideband. So, first you will see the noise in AM amplitude modulation. So, here signal first we are going to know what is the definition for the signal to noise ratio, SNR. So, it is a ratio of the noise power to the input signal power to the noise power. The higher value of the SNR, the greater will be quality of the received output. So, that is based on the signal to noise ratio is high. So, signal is a numerator part, noise is a denominator part. If signal strength is high, so automatically noise will be very low. So, automatically ratio also high. So, overall you can say that the ratio SNR is more than higher value. So, automatically you can say that the received signal reception is high quality. So, there is no any disturbance. So, that is called the signal to noise ratio. So, we are going to have the signal to noise ratio or different points can calculate. So, first one is the input SNR. So, input side. So, SNR I stands for input. So, this is I. So, average power of the modulating signal to the average power of the noise at input side. So, we are going to measure the SNR at input side. So, this is SNR I. Similarly, coming to the SNR out. So, signal to noise ratio output. SNR O gives the output side. So, it is the average power of the demodulated signal because the output side and average power of the noise at the output side. So, first one is the input side, second one is the output side. We are going to take the average power of the demodulated wave. After demodulation, we are going to take the original signal MFT. So, that is the average power of the input signal, that is demodulated signal, and average power of the noise at the output side. Then third one is also channel. So, the signal is transmitting from source, that is input side, to the destination output side. In between, there is a traveling between the channel, through channel. So, that is channel SNR. So, SNR C stands for, this is channel. So, average power of the modulated signal, average power of the noise in message bandwidth. So, during the transmission side. Then coming to the figure of merit. So, what is the definition for the figure of merit? So, it is also one of the important factors for measuring the noise in the any system. So, ratio of the output SNR to the input SNR can be treated as figure of merit. It is a ratio of the SNR to the output side, SNR to the input side. That is the F equal to figure of merit, SNR out O and SNR in. So, it is a ratio of the SNR out to the SNR in is known as a figure of merit. So, figure of merit of a receiver is also SNR out by SNR channel. So, it is a ratio of the SNR output demodulated signal to the channel SNR. So, it is a ratio of the SNR out to the SNR of channel. It is a figure of merit for the receiver part, that is a device. So, these are the different types of the SNRs and the figure of merit. So, consider the following model of AM system. So, we are going to take the modulated wave S of T and input signals carrier signal that the noise can be interpreted by the channel, that is N of T. So, S of T received by the receiver and N of T is a interruption, that is noise signal. So, then there is an arrangement of bandpass filter. So, output of bandpass filter E of T and then once you have removing this noise unwanted signal, then V of T signal can be given to the AM demodulator. Finally, we are going to have the output of modulating signal. So, from this diagram, the S of T equal to amplitude modulated wave AC into 1 plus AM of T cos 2 pi epsilon. This is standard our AM signal we have discussed in the generation of the AM signal. So, S of T equal to AC into 1 plus AM of T cos 2 pi epsilon. is the amplitude sensitivity. So S of T equal to AC cos 2 pi over T by taking expansion AC into K M of T cos 2 pi over T. So this product term is expansion term after multiplication. So from this you can have the power source AC by root 2 whole square AC K M of T root 2 whole square. So in terms of the root mode square mis values, you can calculate the power AC square by 2, AC square K square P by 2. So that is the MS square means you will get the P power. So total power P is equal to AC square 1 plus K square P by 2. So overall the average power of the noise in the message band PNC is equal to W into N naught. Where substituting these values in channel SNR formula, so we will get the SNR, C and AM, so average power of the AM wave and average power of the noise in the message bandwidth. So by calculating these two, we will get the resultant value, PS value. So we will get the SNR channel and amplitude modulation. So this is SNR C into AM, AC square 1 plus KA square into P, 2WN by substituting those values, where P is the power of the message signal, AM square by 2, and where W is the message bandwidth, so the 2W N0 is a bandwidth. Then coming to the output of this one, so V of T, the S of T into plus N of T, so by the same diagram, you can have the summation of the received input signal, standard input signal S of T, and noise interfered during the transmission time. So overall V of T equal to our AC into 1 plus K M of T cos 2 pi over T plus our noise signal N1 of T cos 2 pi over T M of T sin 2 pi over T. It is a in phase and quarter phase components. So what you have discussed in the last class. So overall V of T equal to AC plus AC K M of T plus N1 of T cos 2 pi over T minus N Q of T sin 2 pi over T. So where N I of T and Q of T in phase and quarter phase components of the noise we have discussed in last lessons. Then coming to the output of the AM demodulator is nothing but the envelope of the above signal. So taking the squaring of this one, so we will get the D of T equal to root of AC plus AC KM of T plus NI of T NQ of T whole square. This is approximately we will get the squaring root of AC plus AC KM of T Ni of T only. So we will get the quadrature component will be removed. So we will get the average power of the demodulated signal is Pm equal to Ac Km of T by root 2 whole square. So by taking the squaring of this term, we will get the root 2 whole square root 2 only. So finally Ac square K square P will get the by 2 the average power of the demodulated signal. So once you have the average power of the noise output, Pn0 equal to Wn of T. So by substituting these values in output SNR, so you will get the SNR output and AM. So average power of the demodulated signal, average power of the noise at the output side. So you will get the AC square K square P by 2Wn0. So by substituting these figure of net value of AM, this over F equal to SNR out AM by SNR C AM. So overall F equal to AC square K square P by 2W N0 by AC square 1 plus K square P 2W N0. So overall the figure of merit F equal to K square KP by 1 plus K square P. Therefore the figure of merit of AM receiver is less than the 1 only. So by this, so we are getting K square P by 1 plus K square P means, so the value of the figure of merit F is always less than 1 only. So this is about our noise available in the AM receiver. So you take the any modulation techniques, the signal can be transmitted through the wire or wireless. So even though it is wireless, the signal can be transmitted through the space. So the signal is also may be affected with the noise through the traveling time of the free space. So free space can be act as a media in between the transmitter receiver. So the signal can be affected even though it is not a wireless. So there is effect on the free space which is available in the noise available in the space that affects the signal strength. So that can be observed and analyzed at the receiver side, and then you have to arrange some of the suitable bandpass filters. Those noise can be filtered and get the wanted signal or retrieved signal. Then it will be given to the demodulator. Then finally we are going to get the modulator signal MRT, which is reciprocal to the, which is equal to the faithful reproduction of the input signal MRT. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.